This screencast covers materials from Module 2, Lesson 21, where we continue with our dividing with two-digit divisors and one-digit quotients. I'm only doing a problem or so, and then I'm going on to the word problems. Most of the word problems are from the problem set, and they're not exactly the kind that you'll see on your homework. Nonetheless, I think you'll find it helpful to watch these and see how they are solved. If you don't want to bother, skip through. The last one is from the homework, and it's one that tends to make students pull out their hair. So if you want to just fast forward to that, that's fine. I'm not solving it, but I'll give you some pointers on how to solve the problem. Okay, here we have our standard problem. Again, our steps are going to be estimate, solve, and check. So to estimate, we're going to take our divisor, round it, and 94 rounds to 90. Now I'm going to look for a dividend, rounding the dividend to something that works easily with 90 or the 9. And if I think of my facts with 9s, I know that 72 is pretty close to the 75 here, so I'd say 720 is pretty close to 759. So we'll use 720. 720 divided by 9, well, 72 divided by 9 is 8. Okay, so we are going to try 8 for our divisor, or quotient rather. So again, we'll go to our original problem, 759, in the tableau, our divisor outside. Now I'll try 94 times 8. Regroup the 3. 8 times 9 is 72, plus 3 is 75. Good. I knew it was going to be close, but we see that the 752 is less than the 759. So we'll put our 8 in the quotient. Now we subtract. Very simple. We get a 7. And of course, we cannot get any 94s out of a 7, so we're done. We'll put a remainder of 7. The final step is to check. We know that 759 is going to be the same as 7, and 8 groups of 94. So we had 94 plus 8. We got 752. Let's just try this out again. So 94 times 8, we get 32. Regroup that 3. And 8 times 9 is 72, plus 3 is 75. And we take our 752, and we're going to add our remainder, and we get 759. We see that they match. The answer is correct. This problem tells us to generate and solve at least one more division problem with the same quotient and remainder as the one below. Explain your thought process. Well, this is very similar to what we've done in some of the previous lessons, except this time they're going to ask us to explain what we're doing. All right, well, the first thing I notice here is that we seem to be missing our remainder, and of course, that's easy enough to find. It's down there, so we'll put the R11. So what do we need to do? We need to set up another problem, okay, with the same quotient and remainder as the one below. Explain my thought process. Okay, I'm going to verbally explain this process. First of all, I have no divisor nor dividend. I need to start by making a divisor. I can make one up. Now, there's only one restriction here. Since my remainder is 11, I need to pick a divisor that's greater than 11. So when you start your explanation, you're going to say something like, I need to pick a divisor larger than the remainder. All right, so I'm going to pick a number greater than 11. We can make it easy on ourselves. Let's call it 20. So what do? We now multiply our divisor times our quotient. Then we'll add our remainder, and we'll now have the dividend. So let's do that. 20 times 8. So again, I want to explain what I'm doing here. I'm multiplying my divisor times my quotient, and I get 160. Next, we add the remainder to the product. 160 plus 11 equals 171. And now we have our dividend. And of course, we need to solve that. So we've got all the work pretty much there for us. We know that 20 times 8 is 160. And we subtract and we get 11. Not so hard. Let's read this word problem. Assume that Mrs. Jiang's car travels 14 miles for each gallon of gas. If she travels to visit her niece, who lives 133 miles away, how many gallons of gas will Mrs. Jiang need to make the round trip? Well, here's the key thing here, is this word right here, or these two words, round trip. So whatever we have for our distance, 133, we're going to have to double that. We could represent that with a tape diagram. So one way is 133, and the other way is 133. So we need to find that. Of course, we can multiply 133 times 2. 2 times 133 equals 266. Now, we talk about miles per gallon. So 1 gallon will get her 14 miles. That's getting into 6th grade math, the ratios here. But we have a number of miles here. We have many more than that. So we need to take our 266. We know that 1 gallon gets us 14 miles. How many gallons do we need to make it 266 miles? Well, one for every gallon, it's 14 miles. So let's try some division here. And notice that we have a two-digit quotient this time. So we're going to do some estimating. And I know that, not even going to estimate. I'm going to look at this and I'm going to go 14 and then 28, that's times 1, that's times 2. That's too big, so we're going to go 1. We're going to now subtract, find the difference, and we get 12. 12 is less than 14. The next step now is we need to bring down our 6, because we're regrouping this. We had 12 tens, and now we're going to have 126 ones. Notice that we're going to record our quotient in the ones place for this portion, and this 14 was 14 tens, so that goes in the tens place. So I'm going to ask myself, 14 times what? I know 14 times 10 is 140. That's too big. Let's try 9. So before I do that, I'm going to write 14 times 9. Get a 6, regroup the 3. 9 times 1 is 9, plus 3 is 12. That works out nicely. So we get 126. We subtract, we get a 0. So the answer is 19 miles. Mrs. Cha needs 19 gallons of gas. Moving on to the next problem. Lewis brings 79 pencils to school. After he gives each of his 15 classmates an equal number of pencils, he will give any leftover pencils to his teacher. All right, well, when we talk about leftovers, that means the answer that we're looking for is actually going to be the remainder. Moving along, we have 15 classmates. He's going to distribute those 79 pencils to his classmates equally. That lets us know that we have a division problem. So we have 15 classmates are going to divide 79 pencils. I could do some rounding here. I like my 15s. They're easy to work with. I know that 2 15s is 30. And 4 15s must be 60. And from there I can add 15 more and get to 75 15s. Just showing you some different strategies here. So I'm going to multiply. 5 times 15, I get 75. We subtract. 9 minus 5 is 4. We have a remainder of 4. So Lewis's teacher will receive 4 pencils. Let's look at the next part of this. If Lewis decides instead to take an equal share of pencils along with his classmates, will his teacher receive more or fewer pencils? Show your thinking. All right, well, there were 15, and if Lewis is now going to be among those who are going to share the pencils, we have to increase that number to 16. And we still have 79. Okay, well, I know that 5 times 16 is 80. So that's going to be too big. But it's close, so I'm going to try a 4. Nope, a little mistake there. Regroup that 2, not put it down there. 4. Regroup the 2. 4 times 1 is 4 plus 2 is 6, and we're going to subtract and get a 64. Let's see how that works. Subtracting, 9 minus 4 is 5, and 7 minus 6 is 15. So we have 4. Each one is going to get 4, including Lewis this time. And now his teacher gets 15, and that's a large number, but we know that 15 is less than 16. So Lewis's teacher, his teacher will receive 11 more pencils. All right, on to that homework problem that undoubtedly is vexing many of you. All right, let's read carefully. A lot of things to take care of here. Kind of a hard problem for homework, but not that bad. We just have to think. It takes Juwan exactly 35 minutes by car to get to his grandmother's. The nearest parking area is 5-minute walk from her apartment. One week, he realized he spent 5 hours 12 minutes traveling to her apartment, then back home again. How many round trips did he make to visit his grandmother? Once again, we have that word, round trips. We have to figure out how much one trip takes, and then we have to figure out how much a round trip takes. So let's look at the first part of the problem. It takes Juwan exactly 35 minutes by car to get to his grandmother's. The nearest parking area is a 4-minute walk from her apartment. So what do we have here? Let's represent that on a tape diagram. We have 35 and then 4. But since it's a round trip, we're going to have that twice. So we could represent it in one tape diagram. 35 plus 4. Okay, so this is the round trip in minutes. We don't know what that is. And I'm going to let you figure that out. So, we've got to find the answer to that, but we also have to look at the next part of the problem. One week, he realized he spent 5 hours, 12 minutes traveling to her apartment. Our problem here is that all this information is in minutes, and this is in hours and minutes. So what do we have to do? We have to convert 5 hours to minutes. So 5 hours. Remember that procedure? Equals 5 times 1 hour. Equals 5 times what? Well, we're going to put in units of minutes that are equivalent to 1 hour. We know that there's 60 minutes. I really have given you more than I need to. We're going to find that sum, product, and then we're going to add 12. And then we're going to have to split this total time up into parts that are the same as this. Okay, so these are equal parts. I think that you have the idea what we need to do here. We, of course, we need to divide. And I think you can figure out what the division problem is now, putting together these clues that I've given you, and be successful with this homework. Again, read carefully and make these tape diagrams to help you think things through.